Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, The Unemployed Engineers. Today we are going to learn about the conversion of the source code to the execution file. We'll learn the whole process which is involved from the source code to the executable file, and also I'll be showing the examples how to do that. So the basic process from converting from the source code to the executable file, there are many processes involved as shown in the next slide. See, first the source file is converted to a preprocessor. A preprocessor software will work on the source file and it will generate an assembly code which is given to the compiler. The compiler then checks the assembly codes and see if all the syntaxes and if there is any error in the source file, and if there are no errors, the compiler next gives to the linkers. The linkers then links all the source file, and the C++ standard libraries, and at last gives an executable file. So a source file can have the extension of .cpp, .cc, .cxx, .cp and .C. So the difference between how do we differentiate that the file is a C++ file? If the file has .cpp extension, then we can say that it is a C++ file. See, for example, if we take an music file, the music file will always have an mp3 extension, whereas a video file will be having a .mp4 or .flv or like that. There will be different extensions. Similarly, for C++ source file, they will be having .cpp or .c and .cxx, .cp, .c. But most commonly used extension is .cpp. That is the same extension even I will be using. So I will be showing you an example how this processes works in Dev C++. So we have our Dev C++. First we'll do hash include iostream using namespace std int main return 0. This full thing is called as a source code. The whole thing is called as a source code. So I have saved this in a file called A files. So this one is called a source file, and whatever the code presents inside the source file is called a source code. This is called a source code, right? So this is the source code. So what this is called as the header, and the header always contains a standard C++ library which is the iostream. These libraries are required for doing the basic operations in the C++, like printing the statement on the screen or going to the next line. All those are done in using this library called iostream. The meaning of iostream means input output streams. As I said, it is the standard std library which is used for displaying the output on the console, or taking the input from the user and displaying the output on the console. All the basic things are done using this std library. So as I showed in the file, in the source file, we are going to write all the source code, and after writing the source code and if while hitting the compile, the source code is going to the preprocessor statement. What happens in the preprocessor statement is that all these this whatever we are writing inside this hash, maybe if I write hash include CSTDLIB, whatever is written inside the hash, all of those libraries will be put in this file using the preprocessor. So I'll repeat again, when we compile the source code, the source code is given to the preprocessor. The preprocessor will process all the codes written in this hash. As you can see, whatever is written in the hash here and here, all the libraries will be included to this file. After which the compilation process will happen. So in the compiler process, it will check if there are any errors in the code, like for every line of code we write there should be a semicolon. If the semicolon is missing, the compiler will generate an error saying that there is a semicolon missing in this particular line. See, all that is done by the compiler. See, once the compiler compiles the source code, it will give an assembly code. Right, the assembly code is then given to the linkers. So what is linkers will do is that, see, here I've just written one source file, but in consider a large project, there won't be a single file, okay? There'll be many different files associated. All those files should be converted to one executable file. That process is done using the linkers. The linkers will join all the different files together to give out an output of a single executable file. So let me write here a statement, cout. Let me say this is an employed engineer's channel and end line. Okay, consider that I haven't written the semicolon, which is an error, and if I compile and run, now the preprocessor is finished. Now it is given to the compiler. See, the compiler says that the semicolon is missing. So if I put the semicolon and again if I compile and run, it will do the preprocessing and it will do the compilation, and the linking is also done. And you can see the output, which is given in the console. So if I open the file and see this is the source code and this is the output generated executable file. If you go to the properties and if we check the extension of this, see, we can see that it is .exe, which means that this is the executable file which is generated from this source file. So this is the whole process as I've shown here, from the source file to the executable file. And in the next video, I'll be showing you how to write the simple program in the C++ of printing hello world. Okay. Do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.